Hello everyone, Ashley here from Eastridge High School to bring you the math problem of the week. And then it's asking, which of the statements is true? A, the function's absolute minimum is the x-intercept. B, the point corresponding to the function's absolute maximum is above its y-intercept. C, the function has a relative minimum of negative 3 or 3. Or D, the function's absolute maximum is 5. So let's look at A. The function's absolute minimum is the x-intercept. So our x-intercepts will be found here and here when the y is 0. And as you can see, the graph still continues under, so it will not be the absolute maximum. So we can rule out A. B, the point corresponding to the function's absolute maximum is above its y-intercept. The y-intercept would be when x is 0. So our y-intercept would be 5. And that is the absolute maximum. It does not go above the y-intercept. So we can rule B out. C, the function has a relative minimum of negative 3. The relative minimum is talking about the y-axis, which will be right here, negative 3. But these arrows indicate that the graph is continuous, so it would go below negative 3. So C is out. Our last answer is D. The function's absolute maximum is 5. Now, how we were talking about in B, the graph stops right here and does not go over it. So the absolute maximum would be 5. So which of the statements is true? D, the function's absolute maximum is 5.